No, not really. Do I have any big plans? No big plans. I guess this is like a garage update. After I clean it up, mainly prioritizing as many of the dead rats out as possible. I actually there is a dead rat that is hidden. It is inside the serape. There's two serapes blankets. There's a dead rat in between there, inside the box. I haven't gone to. And I don't want to throw the serapes away, like permanent, just because of the dead rat is there. So now I have to sift through, find the dead rat, peel him off the serapes, and then wash the serapes. Then there's also a massive box, completely opened, filled with old clothes, old clothing. Now, because this old clothing box has been available for rats who have had decom, who've had these terrible poisons, because they go into anything warm and fluffy, they just die. It's just the way it goes, because they hurt. So this box, chances are, has so many dead rats in it, mingled in with my clothing. Specifically, my clothing only. I'm not really sure if I can handle going through the box. And it's a huge box. It's like 3 feet by 3 feet. And it's filled with clothing and possibly many rats that have passed away. So I'm kind of tormented there. I could take it out into the open. Take it out of the garage. I think I have to take it out of the garage and maybe just dump it out, like throw it out upside down, like everywhere, and just spread everything out all over the place. I'm not sure. Does anybody know the technique for such a thing? Because I'm here, I'm recycle world here, but when you have the dead animals inside the recycling items, it kind of just, I don't know how far I can go with the keeping, you know what I mean? Because I really want to just torch the entire box. I want to take the box and light it on fire, and many other things also. I would love to torch, but now I hear we're not allowed to torch in this area at all. I can't burn anything, and I really need to burn things. Like, because of the poison, because of what's happened. I believe they use this cyanides, they use this resin or something. They use something else. I don't know. Oh, it was gross. It's just a gross situation. And I'm supposed to paint in there, or no, I can't paint in there. And I'm supposed to sleep in there, and I'm like, no, I can't sleep in there. So I'm not really sure what's gonna happen. I have to. I mean, it's almost like a ruined space. You know what I mean? A ruined area of the planet. And yeah, so I'm not really sure what to do. I have to drive, get a new windshield, and you have to get this new car blow up airbag thing fixed because of a recall. So it's like my, and then apparently the car needs to be serviced on the 13th on top of everything else. So I need all of these things that just have to keep happening, have to keep happening. And so who am I at the end of the day? I'm the chauffeur for the car to be repaired. I am the one who cleans out the dead rats. And who am I? Who am I? My payment. What is my payment? What is my payment? I don't know. Some people would be begging to die, I think so, right about now, if they knew my life. Yeah, I asked for that marijuana already because I'm in California I announced to the neighbors how much I'm in desperate need of it. Perhaps they heard me. Perhaps they will request it with their doctors. Could you please send her some? I don't know. None of the sheets are beautiful and clean enough to cart me out of here with. Filled with nasty, nasty rat poisons. So now I can't really die. I know, that's a sick joke, huh? I know it. But anyway, that is the truth. That is a definite truth. Gosh, dang it. Should I wear a mask out there? I don't have a mask. Just how did it happen? How did an entire generation of people make a preference for pesticides over the absolute truth? Well, if it kills the rats, what does it do to me also?